Hey everyone, welcome back to Zimist Coded, your go-to channel for programming and IT tutorials. Today, we'll dive into the world of Microsoft Word and learn how to craft a professional progress bar to enhance your resumes. I'm excited to guide you through each step, so let's get started. Step 1. Insert the rounded rectangle. Begin by navigating to the Insert tab and selecting Rectangle, Rounded Corners from the illustration group. Drag the shape onto your page and opt for the rounded corners to allow for more customization. Step 2. Customize the shape. Click on the shape, then head to the Shape Format tab. Either click on the little icon in the Shape Style group or right-click on the shape and choose Format Shape. Here, you'll find options to modify the outline and fill of the shape. Step 3. Adjust the outline. In the Line group, choose Solid Line and change the color to your preference, such as orange. You can also adjust the thickness of the outline. Step 4. Create a gradient fill for the progress bar. To achieve the progress bar effect, go to the Fill options and select Gradient Fill. Choose Linear as the gradient type, set the angle to 0 degrees, and add 4 gradient stops. Ensure the first and second stops are orange, and the third and fourth stops are dark gray. Position them at 0%, 40%, 40%, and 100%, respectively. Step 5. Customize the progress percentage. Make the second and third stops collide at the desired percentage, e.g. 40%, to represent your progress. Always set the orange stop before the dark gray for these stops. Adjust them to match the percentage you want for your progress bar. Step 6. Add text to the shape. Right-click on the shape and choose Add Text to include the percentage text on your progress bar. Feel free to customize the shape further to suit your needs. There you have it, a step-by-step guide to creating a professional progress bar for your resumes using regular shapes in MS Word. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting content. Keep coding, keep learning, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.